delicate. Give it up for family number one.
Yep, game number two is commencing.
Accomplished. And hip is how they describe themselves. They join us from Pierre. Give him a hand, family number two.
Yep, this is game two of our Family Feud Marathon. Pierre is in South Dakota, I believe.
Our two families will be doing battle for big bucks on the Family Feud.
Yeah, Mikey's dumb answer to the survey, and Chap's first answer got us to 10 grand.
Louie Anderson.
Here we go, game number two.
Welcome to the Feud. We've got a great game lined up for you. Let's get started.
Let's do this.
We surveyed 100 people, top 5 answers
top
up on the board.
Top 5 answers.
Here we go. Everybody ready?
Yes.
Tell me an occupation whose members seems as if they get to live by different rules.
Tell me an occupation whose members seem as if they get to live by different rules. I'm gonna say a police officer.
Your answer, family number one. Let's see if it's up there.
I'll be right back.
It's there, but what answer is more popular?
All right.
Number two answer. Only one's gonna beat it. Next family.
Occupation of the
I'll repeat the question. Name an occupation whose members seem as if they get to live by different rules. They said an explorer.
All right. Let's see if it's on the board.
An explorer is not an occupation. You know what? I'll give this question a try. We'll play.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top five.
Yeah.
Are you gonna play?
But we're in the 21st century.
Gonna play? Let's go.
All right. Gonna play? Let's go.
That's dubious.
Yes, indeed, Chapo.
Another player. We need another.
I will say, politician.
Tell me an occupation whose members seem as if they get to live by different rules. Okay. Show me the answer.
Looking for a politician. Number one answer.
Politician.
Cool.
You got it. Our number one answer. Another player, okay.
I'm going to go with, how about...
Tell me an occupation whose member seems... as if they get to live by different rules.
No. How about construction?
Is it there? Show us!
Strike one.
Strike one, sorry.
Oh, well. Bless you.
Next player, let's go.
How about lawyers?
Tell me an occupation whose members seem as if they get to live by different rules. All right, show me that answer.
It's there, said by 10 people.
Yeah. Exactly.
Exactly. I'm gonna say a judge.
Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Tell me an occupation whose members seem as if they get to live by different rules. You never know what's gonna be up there. Survey says...
Let's see a judge. Not there. In your face, Judge Judy.
It's not there. Second strike.
I'll be right back.
Family number two, one more strike, and you get a chance to steal. Next player, what's your guess?
I'm gonna say...
Tell me an occupation whose member seems as if they get to live by different rules. Survey said...
It's there, said by three people.
Yes, indeed.
Absolutely.
I will go with... You know what?
Next player, what's your guess?
I'm going to go with an accountant.
Tell me an occupation whose member seems...
No.
If they get to live by different rules.
No. No. I'll try another one. A teacher!
Is it there? Let's see.
It's not there. Well, we got 4 out of 5. That's not bad.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top 5.
What will it be? Next player, let's go.
Tell me an occupation whose member seems as if
musicians.
They get to live by different rules.
All right, let's see if it's on the board.
False! We got the points.
Yeah.
Good guess, but it's not up there. Family number one, you did it. Way to go.
Oh, yeah.
And to wrap things up.
What was that last answer we couldn't come up with? Pro athlete.
That takes us to the end of this round.
I should have thought of that, but I didn't. Board. Oh, well. What do you gotta do?
Family number one, you're playing great.
Thanks, Louie. Go ahead and turn the laptop towards me a little bit.
Let's go. It's time for round two. Come on, another player for me, Sam. A 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers are on the board. We're looking for the most popular answer.
Everybody ready? Tell me the one bill that you'd love to have paid off.
The one bill you'd love to have paid off? Credit card.
Your answer, family number one.
I know that's the case with me.
Okay, show me the answer.
It's there, but two answers are more popular.
Very good. But there's two up there that can beat it. Next family gets a chance. Family number two.
Hospital bill.
Is it there?
Now that depends on what you were in the hospital for.
Four.
Survey says we're gonna play.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top 4. Are you gonna play? Gonna play? Let's go.
And we got to hear that again. Actually, he said, gonna play? Let's go.
Another player. We need another answer.
Hopefully he'll say good answer in a little bit. One bill you'd love to have paid off. I got
one. Bill that you'd love to have paid off.
I'm gonna say mortgage.
All right, show me that answer.
It's there, number one answer, mortgage house.
Mortgage house? Yeah!
our top answer. Way to go.
$1 billion you'd love to have paid off.
Next family member.
How about car payments?
Tell me the one bill that you'd love to have paid off. You never know what's going to get there. Survey says.
It's there. One answer left.
Excellent. Absolutely.
We have mortgage house, we have car payments, and we have, what was that? A credit card.
Another player, okay. Got an answer for it?
How about, student loans?
Tell me the one bill that you'd love to have paid off.
You're telling me.
We're gonna go student loan.
All right. Let's see if it's on the board.
It's there. We got it.
Yeah. You got all of them. Well done.
Nice.
Give family number one those points. Let's see how our family's doing after round two.
We're off and running, Louie. 178 to a big fat donut, aka nada.
You gotta command your people. Okay, it's round three. Let's go.
Okay, it's round three. Let's go.
I need two more players up here. Let's go.
Here we go.
Surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers up on the board. Try to guess the most popular one.
Top 7. Okay.
Everybody ready? When a teenager runs away from home, name something that might happen that would make them come home again.
I would say a death.
Family number one.
No. Illness.
Is it there? Let's see.
It's there, but two answers are more popular.
Yeah! Good answer. But there's a couple that can beat it. So let's see what our next family says. Okay, family number two.
No place to go.
Survey says?
I think, once again, I'm going to throw a touchdown pass.
I thought I would be up there. Sorry. What are you going to do? Play or pass? Pass? All right, then. Next player, what's your guess? When a teenager runs away from home, name something
bad weather
that would make them come home again.
Well, maybe, but
I hope it's up there for you.
Nope, strike one.
Oh, well.
Nice try, but no. Your first strike.
Oh.
Another player. We need another answer. When a teenager runs away from home, name something that might happen that would make them come home again. All right, let's see if it's on the board.
It's there.
Yeah! Absolutely. Next player, what's your guess? When a teenager runs away from home, name something that might...
Intercession by clergy!
Do what?
I hope... hope it's up there for you.
Give him another strike.
What did they say?
Intercession by clergy.
Oh, well.
Uh-oh. That's strike number two.
What?
I-N-T-E-R-C-E-S-S-I-O-N.
Maybe number one. One more strike and you're up. Next family member. What do you
say? But it's not there.
When a teenager runs away from home, name something
hungry.
That
oh, that's a good one.
Come home again. You never know what's going to be up there. Survey says.
Right on.
Exactly.
Bazoo, Mikey. Keep that up, and I'll give you another.
Another player. You need another answer. When a teenager runs away from home, name something
get
that might
beat
happen
up.
That would make them come home again.
Oh, yeah. My boyfriend.
You never know what's going to be up there.
Mikey's in timeout.
Oh, well.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top seven.
Yeah.
Power of Christ compels you.
Your turn. Next player. Let's go.
Mikey?
Yeah.
When a teenager runs
misbehaving,
home,
we'll put you in timeout again.
Happen that would make them come home again. Survey said.
Shoo!
No money. All right.
Actually, chat, let me do the honors.
Our top answer. Way to go.
Shoo!
All right, family number one.
And then I'll let you say whatever you want when it gets back.
Let's see what was in four.
Mikey, all I can say is, way to go,
the
asshole.
The sixth most popular answer. And lastly...
Thank you, Michael Henry.
Let's check out how both families are doing after this round.
No, it's not a good one.
And again, Mikey, the power of Christ compels you.
It's game. Both families are playing well.
One thing I will not give up for Lent is answers.
That's fine by me.
In round four, points are triple.
What am I giving
but
up for Lent?
One strike.
Nothing.
Then the other family gets a chance to steal. Let's play. Two more players and we can get going. Let's do it.
Round four.
100 people surveyed. Top four answers are on the board. We're looking for the most popular answer. Good luck. Ready? Name a door that you should always knock on before entering.
The the bedroom door.
The porta potty.
What do you think it is, family number one? Is it there? Shut up!
It's there, but what answer is more popular when you put triple the points?
Number
that's
two answer.
69.
Only one's gonna beat it. Next family. What do you think it is, family number two?
The front door. I was thinking that.
I want to see that answer.
I'm wondering if I should have gone with that first. It's not even there, so I'm okay.
No.
Sorry, but it's not one of our top answers.
I'm going to play.
We need a decision. Play or play? You're playing? Okay.
Okay.
Another player, okay. Got an answer for us?
Bathroom.
Name a door that you should always knock on before entering. All right, let's see if it's on the board.
Number one answer, bathroom.
Bathroom.
Yeah.
Good answer. Number one.
Door you should always knock on before entering. We have bathroom, we have bedroom.
That's better. Let's go.
A man's stomach?
That's not a door.
Name a door that you should always knock on before entering.
Oh, it's not a door. It's a stair.
Door shell is not gone before entering. I'm drawing a blank.
I am too, maybe an office?
Quickly.
No.
Hurry, we're running out of time.
Really?
I got nothing.
Is it there? Show us!
The other family gets this, they win.
Good guess, but no. Gotta give you a strike. A chance to steal coming up. It's your turn. Next player, let's go. Name a door that you should always knock on before entering.
Doctor's office.
All right.
That better not be up there. Thank God.
No.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our
top four. So, chap, would you like to go second again, or would you like me to do it?
Yeah, I can do it again.
All right, you got it.
Yes, family number one gets the points. What was in third? And last but
someone's
not least.
Someone's house. That's what I was trying to say. Boss's office. But they weren't
that
showing
takes
up.
Us to the end of this round. Let's check the scoreboard.
Oh, well. We still win, so it's okay.
What a terrific game. Congratulations, everyone. The Fast Money Round is coming up with our top money winner, family number one.
All right, so Mikey, you're first, chapter second.
It's the Fast Money Round. I need two players from your team, and we'll get going.
All right, Mikey, are you ready?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Five questions. Good luck. The clock starts when I finish reading the first question.
All right, so Mikey. Name something tacos are filled with.
Meat.
Of course. Name the age when men start losing their hair.
40.
Okay.
Name the
fruit with the nicest smell.
Name the fruit with the nicest smell.
Yeah.
Orange.
Okay.
Name a kind of
repairman you might have to stay home from work to let into your home.
Electrician.
All right.
It's dumb answer
time.
Name the month when you
Mikey?
Watch the least TV.
Name the month when you watch the least TV.
Christmas.
That's a holiday, not a month.
Well,
no!
Let's see how you did.
Well, let's see how you did.
Something tacos are filled with.
Filled with meat. Survey said? 24.
Name the age when men start losing their hair.
Age 40. Survey said? 25.
Name the fruit with the nicest smell.
An orange. Our survey said? 28.
Name the kind of repairman that you might have to stay home from work to let into your home.
You said an electrician. Survey said? 3.
Name the month when you watch the least TV.
You said the month of Christmas. That's a holiday. Survey said? Nothing. All right, chat.
Same 5 questions.
Mikey got you 80 points.
Starts when I finish the first question.
Need 120, but you can do it. Are you ready?
Alright.
Chat, name something tacos are filled
name
with.
Tacos are filled with.
Jeez.
Absolutely. Name the age when men start losing their hair. Good. Now name the fruit with the nicest smell. All right. Name a kind of repairman you might have to stay home from work to let into your home.
Plumber.
Good. I was hoping you'd say that. And name the month you watch the least TV.
Name the month when you watch the least TV.
July.
Good. Did Chap do it? Let's find out.
Let's check it out and see how you did.
Name something tacos are filled with. You said cheese. That was the number one answer. Survey said? Oh, wait, no, it wasn't. I'm sorry. 23 people said it. I thought it would be number one. It's okay.
Name the age when men start losing their hair.
You said 50. What'd the survey say on that one? 3 only? Oh, shoot. Fruit with the nicest smell. Strawberries was number one. You said an apple. 6. We're going to have to hope for 2 big finishes.
Name a kind of repairman that you might have to stay home from work.
You said a plumber.
Right into your home.
That was the number one answer for sure. Survey said? 49! Did 39 people say July for $10,000? We got it! Yes!
Congratulations, you won!
Good job, Chap and Mikey! So we are now 2 for 2 on $10,000 wins. Are we going to go 3 for 3? We'll find out in a moment.
See you next time for another game on Family Feud.
Yeah. And we'll be back.